and lights. We make our own fun throughout the night. We're gonna feel this good forever. Such heights we reach together. No matter what, stepping in time, tread our own path, we won't fall down.
Hey, what's up guys? It's Rick with the Digital Divide. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Nintendo Switch. Nintendo just recently announced their new OLED model, and we're going to talk about whether or not I think it's worth buying and who should buy it, and actually if any Nintendo Switch is worth buying for new people in 2021. Now, there's all kinds of different people out in the world, but for gaming, I think primarily for the Switch, there are people who prefer to play in handheld mode. Then there's people that prefer to play on the big screen, and then there's people that play both pretty much equally. So let's take a look at some of the additions that Nintendo added to the OLED model. The biggest addition is the OLED screen. That's going to give you deeper blacks and brighter colors. The screen is actually a little bit bigger as well. It's 7 inches, so you have a bit more real estate, and they did that by trimming down the bezel. It's not physically any bigger, so it will still sit inside of your docking station for the TV. Now, the other big addition is it has a much, much better kickstand. The one that originally launched with the Switch was very flimsy and did not adjust. It only had one angle. This one is much more sturdy and has a variety of viewing angles. The next biggest addition is enhanced audio. The speakers are of better quality. The next biggest addition here is that it's got a wired LAN port in the docking station itself. Now, this is something I think should have been in a launch model, but if your wireless isn't strong and you want a faster connection for download speed, then this is definitely a welcome addition. If you've been paying attention though, you'll notice that of all the upgrades in the OLED model, they're pretty much all only going to apply in handheld mode, with the exception of that Ethernet port. All the rest of them only apply if you're playing in handheld mode. So if you're somebody that plays primarily in handheld mode and you don't already have a Switch, then in my opinion, I give this a thumbs up. It's definitely worth picking up in that specific scenario, but if you already have a Switch, and you play primarily in TV mode, or you don't want to spend the extra $350 just to get an OLED screen, I really don't think it's worth it, in my opinion, for the $350 just to have a slightly darker darks and an Ethernet port. But is it worth buying any version of the Nintendo Switch in 2021? Well, the PlayStation 5 is still pretty much impossible to find, so is the Xbox Series X, unless you want to pay scalper prices. So if you haven't already jumped on the Nintendo Switch bandwagon, is it worth buying either the OG Switch or the Nintendo Lite right now in 2021? Well, it really depends. If you're looking for like the top tier AAA, like amazing visuals and audio experience from next gen consoles, then probably not. But in my opinion, the Nintendo Switch is by far the best place to play indie titles. So if you like indie titles, then go for it. Or the biggest reason to buy the Switch is to play the Nintendo exclusive. Make no doubt about it, the Nintendo Switch and most Nintendo hardware is a place to play Nintendo's amazing exclusive first-party developed library. Now, this is my Nintendo Switch Lite. I've had it for a while, and I love it. I play it all the time. It's a great console. The battery life is great. You know, and if you slap in a micro SD card, it's got plenty of storage options. Nintendo still is putting out a lot of great first-party content and even third-party exclusives. If you watch my channel, you know that Panzer Dragoon is one of my favorite games of all time. The Sega Saturn is one of my favorite consoles of all time, and I absolutely love this game. And as of right now, you can only play this on the Nintendo Switch or on a PC. It is not on any other console as far as I'm aware, so Nintendo does on occasion nab some pretty cool exclusives for their handheld consoles. This game came out last year. Highly recommend it if you're a fan of old school Sega Saturn games. Now, the next game I want to highlight here that is completely exclusive to the Switch is Marvel Ultimate Alliance. This game is actually the reason why I bought a Switch, just to play this game. If you're a fan of the previous Ultimate Alliance games, this is an amazing game. It is so much fun. And again, it is only on the Switch. So even though the Switch primarily is a first-party console to play Nintendo games, they do occasionally get some really, really amazing top-tier exclusives. And this is one of them. This is a game I still play all the time. Absolutely love it. The next game I want to highlight here is a brand new exclusive for the Switch that just came out a few days ago. This is the new Cruising USA game. Now, this game is interesting because it actually started off life in the arcades as Super Bikes 3, and I played this at my local arcade, and I thought, man, this game is really fun, visuals are really impressive, and I got online to see if it had been ported to any consoles, and it hadn't, because I wanted to buy it on my PlayStation, but it wasn't there, it wasn't on PC, so I was pretty much bummed out. And then I found out that the game was actually being ported over to the Nintendo Switch as a new Cruising USA title. And it is so much fun. I picked it up the day it launched, and I can't get enough of it. It's a lot of fun. It reminds me of the old school cruising games on the Nintendo 64. And I highly recommend it. It's only $39.99, so it's not a full price title, but it's so much fun. And the tracks are super inventive. So, is it worth buying any version of the Nintendo Switch in 2021? Is the big question here, and it really, really depends. As I stated earlier, I think that the OLED model, it has some neat perks, but it's a bit expensive at $350. For only $50 more, you can get a PlayStation 5 digital console or an Xbox Series console. You know, so it's a mixed bag. If you can get a used console, especially a Switch Lite, for like between $100 and $150, I think it's absolutely worth it. Or if you can get a deal on the docked version for cheaper than its MSRP, I think it's worth it. But there are some rumors as recent as this week saying that Nintendo is still developing a Switch Pro model that will do 4K. So I don't know if it's necessarily worth buying at full price right now if they're going to release a better model in the next 2 years. But Nintendo still does have some amazing exclusives planned down the road, including Zelda Breath of the Wild 2, Bayonetta 3, and Metroid Dread, just to name a few. So if you're a huge fan of Nintendo-developed games, I think it is a great console. I just think that you need to get it for the right price. But overall, absolutely worth buying. I have a lot of fun with mine, and I highly recommend it. So that's going to do it for me today, guys. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, and thank you for watching.